stand, please. My privilege to welcome you to the Josh and Felicia wedding, and I would ask, who gives the bride?
Her mother and I.
All right, thank you. And you all may be seated. Let me express appreciation to friends and family for being here and make sure that you understand what is actually happening here. I honor Josh and Felicia with this request. In my own words, their desire is to profess their love for each other before God and man, but also to those of you that are family and friends, to make sure that you understand who Jesus Christ is to them. And that they take their faith most seriously, and that they're expressing that to you today in such a way in heart's desire that when you come to the end of your days and you have made the choice, their prayer is that you've made the right choice. The Bible says there is no other name under heaven by which you might be saved. And so I'd ask you to pray with me. The Bible makes this promise. If we pray in the name of Jesus, and we pray asking God's will to be done, we have a promise from God that that prayer will be answered. So would you join me in praying for this couple? Father in heaven, we humble ourselves and come asking that your will would be done. Not arbitrarily, God, but specifically, we would pray in the name of Jesus. And we thank you, Lord, for his wonderful life, his sinless life, and then the fact that you gave him to be sacrifice for our sin, and you have paid that sin debt, and we stand here today as a visible witness, for the Bible speaks of Christ coming as the bridegroom and the church to be his bride without spot and without blemish. We ask, Lord, that you would be with Josh, who comes in this moment as a man, but he will leave this auditorium as a husband, and Felicia, who comes as a woman, who will leave this auditorium as a wife. That as they pledge their love, we ask the mercies of heaven upon them from this day. And as long as you give them the breath of life, we pray all of this in Jesus' name. Amen. It's been a good time for me to get to know Josh and Felicia. The first time I saw Josh, I wondered about him and wondered who he was, and we began to have conversations. And I would say this, apart from my immediate family, I've spent more time with Josh Barnes in the last 2 years than any other man that I know. Because you see, he comes to me with some hard questions, but he also shares wisdom and insight from his reading and his experience. And I got to know him in that way, and then it was to my joy to discover with a delight who Felicia Buss is, to have conversations. She's beautiful and somewhat rather quiet, but given an opportunity to get to know her, she is well-grounded and well-read, an ambitious young lady, one to be admired. And so in their conversation of processing and getting to know each other, they've been ever so careful to come to this time. They've come to me even before they had decided that they might get married to have a conversation about what that might look like and what my response would be to that and sharing in this. And so I offer these words not only to the family and friends, but even to Josh and Felicia, that what we're experiencing here today didn't start two and a half years ago. It started with creation. that at the very creation, God had a plan, and a plan that included today, that you're here. You're not here by accident. You're not here by chance. You might deny, but you're here by the purpose and the plan of Almighty God. And in the book of Genesis, it says that when God made Adam, the first man, our great ancestor, God concluded it would not be good for man to be alone. He needed that one to come along to be his helpmate, to finish him, to make him the better man. And so what we see today is that Josh, to his delight, has discovered one who will love him in that way, and he in turn will love her. It's interesting because I've had some conversation with them. In fact, I have to tell you this. The ceremony, if you would, was planned by Josh and the pastor. Felicia was nowhere to be seen, and I must tell you, I was rather undone, not sure, because the bride generally has much to say about this time. She did see it in writing, and but their conclusion was that they wanted vows to be ever so simple and straightforward, vows that could be answered with a yes or a no. But I would offer to you what it says in the book of Genesis, also in the book of Ephesians, where it says, "For this reason, a man will leave his father and mother and be joined to his wife, and the two will become one flesh." What we're experiencing here today is becoming a novelty, especially in America. There's so much redefinition of what it means to be a man, what it means to be a woman. But under heaven, both Josh and Felicia have professed that Jesus is not only the Lord, he is their Savior. And what they're asking you to do is to be a blessing to them. So before I get to their vows, I want to give you an opportunity to make a vow. In fact, Jesus said your vow ought to be yes or no. That means not without equivocation, without discussion. But I want to ask you, where it says in God's purpose and plan for today, will you vow to not come between the one flesh of Josh and Felicia? Yes or no? Yes. To mothers and mothers-in-laws in a moment, will you vow to support the choice of your child in this relationship, not only today, but in the days to come? To you family and friends, the extended family and friends, will you vow to not choose a side? There is no side in the ideal of God in marriage. There is one side. It's God's side. Will you vow not to give wisdom or choose sides, wisdom being advice or wise counsel that you think you might know better, or you might know something that the other party would not know? Will you vow to be the kind of friend that will honor what they've asked of you today? Yes or no?
Yes.
Thank you. So Josh and Felicia, allow me then to take your vows from Scripture. They moved. All right. Hold on a second. Yeah, it's in here. There it is. Wrong book. So out of 1 Thessalonians chapter 5, toward the end of this letter to the Christians in the first century. Josh, my first question is, have you come to this occasion of your own free will?
Yes, I have.
All right. It says in 1 Thessalonians chapter 5, verse 16, it's a command, but will you rejoice always?
Yes.
Will you pray constantly?
Yes.
Will you give thanks in everything?
Yes.
Do you vow not to stifle the Spirit?
Yes.
Do you vow to not despise prophecies but test all things?
Yes.
Do you vow to hold on to that which is good?
Yes.
Do you vow to stay away from every form of evil?
Yes.
Felicia, I ask you the same questions. Do you vow to rejoice always?
Yes.
Do you vow to pray constantly?
Yes.
Do you vow to give thanks in everything? Do you vow to not stifle the Spirit? Do you vow not to despise prophecies but test all things?
Yes.
Do you vow to hold on to that which is good?
Yes.
Do you vow to stay away from every form of evil? What I've heard these couples do is profess with love, a love for each other and a love for the Lord. What I believe about them to be true is they love each other, and in this time they will pray for and with each other. Out of the uniqueness of marriage, they will devote themselves to serve each other. And in God's ideal, no longer will they be friends only. They will be husband and wife and friends. Let's pray. Father, we ask now in the wonderful name of Jesus all the blessings of heaven. And thank you, Lord, for this occasion where we celebrate the union of a man and a woman out of the very plan and purposes of God for this day. In Jesus' name, amen. Do you have the rings? Josh, would you take Felicia by the hand and place the ring on her finger, please? And repeat after me. I pledge my love to you.
I pledge my love to you.
And this ring.
And this ring.
Marks or shows.
Marks or shows.
The love that I have for you in my heart.
The love that I have for you in my heart.
Felicia, would you place the ring on Josh's ring finger? And say after me, this ring. I give to you as a sign and symbol of the love that I have for you in my heart. Would you like to kiss the bride?
I'd like that.
Okay. By the authority of God, I pronounce you no longer man and woman, but husband and wife. May I be the first to congratulate and introduce to you Mr. and Mrs. Josh Barnes. Give you some instructions in just a moment. The parents, if you'd like, there's going to be a receiving line right back there. You don't have to be in it if you choose not to. But for those of you that are not going to go to Island Park, this is your opportunity to give well wishes to the bride and the groom. So they'll be there in a moment to greet you as you leave the auditorium. And then also it will take just a little while for them to have the receiving line, to get the wedding license signed, to get some clothes changed, and especially some additional pictures taken. And so it'll be a little while before they see you at Island Park, but hope that you're able to come and participate in that. And if you ask me where it is, if you will drive out of the building, parking lot, and head towards the ocean,